So basically, we all know that life is not very predictable. Most of the times, the cases do well. Some other days, you end up with PVR. So what to do? So basically, you have to assess very well what is the cause for the PVR. Basically, keep your calm, don't panic. And the approaches, we'll just see the few approaches to manage such cases. So it could be because of the incomplete membrane peeling, intrinsic contracture of the retina, post-silicon oil proliferation. So peeling the membranes is of utmost importance. Many times you don't have to really remove the oil to peel the membrane. You can do membrane peeling under the oil also. Basically, you pull away from the posterior pole towards the periphery because the retina is thick there, so you're unlikely to tear the retina. So here the membrane has been peeled. Here also this anterior membranes, these are also being peeled under oil. So good magnification and good visibility is the crux. So you can use IVTA to stain the membranes. And in some cases, you can do ILM peeling at the posterior pole. So that will prevent further reproliferation at the posterior pole. You can use PFCL also, or it can be done under saline field also. And sometimes you need to relax yourself also and the retina also. And you can assess if you're doing FG, if there's a contraction, then the air can go subretinal. In that case, you may have to enlarge the retinotomy or you may have to do retinectomy. So here, there's a sort of, in spite of membrane peeling, the retina is not going back. So adequate retinectomy is of utmost importance. If you do a really very small one, it's not going to serve any purpose. Then again, it's going to lift up. Do a good cautery and see to that you remove the anterior flap of the retina also. This is another case. Because hemostasis has to be good, because the blood itself is a good culture medium for PVR. Here I am putting PFCL, so you can see one of the edges is a little stiff, and I was trying to extend that by doing cautery, and the PFCL goes subretinally. So in such cases, you may have to again remove the PFCL, again inject, and then I'm enlarging the retinectomy. So almost 360 retinectomy was required in this case. So PFCL is a great help in managing PVR cases. So this is the same case. And sometimes the retina may lift up just because of the sort of intrinsic contraction at the edge. So you'll have to freshen the edges, do a cautery, and you can retrim the edge and then put PFCL and then do laser. And you should not forget that PVR involves the pre-retinal and subretinal also. So here, in spite of PFCL, the retina is folded. So you can see the subretinal bands there. So these bands have to be removed. So it's a big sheet of almost 5 to 6. So once these subretinal bands were removed, the retina became more sort of pliable and it settled back. And then good laser and then PFCL. Oil exchange can be done. And sometimes you can end up with subretinal oil that is below the retina. In such cases, you have to do a large retinectomy to really release that trapped silicone oil, so that it floats up and then it can be removed and then you can attach the retina again. So basically, you have to ascertain the cause of detachment. Prevention is the best thing. So see to that you remove all the membranes, use high magnification, use IVTA, and if you do a good job, most of the cases can be reattached and the patient can have useful vision. Thanks a lot.